Hello, everyone. I'm Dean Barber, founder and CEO of Barber Financial Group. Logan DeGrave, certified financial planner, and I today are going to be discussing making large purchases in retirement. Retirement is supposed to be that time of your life where you're doing all the things that you want to do. And sometimes we see people foregoing things that they can actually do because they don't have the clarity that they need. Enjoy the conversation with Logan and I. I'm Dean Barber, founder and CEO of Barber Financial Group, along with Logan DeGrave. Logan's one of our certified financial planners. Logan, welcome. We're here to talk about making big purchases in retirement. And I want to set the stage here because a lot of people, when they go into retirement, they think about what they want to, that retirement to look like. They lay out the plans. You go through a lot of work, and inevitably, people get 2 or 3 or 4 years into retirement and they find some things that maybe they didn't think about before because they've actually had some time to really think about things, experience some things. And so now they're saying, hey, what would happen if I wanted to buy a second home? What would happen if I wanted to do something for a child or a grandchild? And there's all these things that come up. And so we're going to talk today about how people make those decisions in retirement, because so many people, if they don't have that plan put together, what they do is they just say, well, that wasn't in our plan, so we can't do it.
I got one better for you too, Dean, right? It's not me in retirement, because you are right. Every day's a Saturday. You got a lot more time to think. But think about this, right? People come in, right, 5 years from retirement, and they say, hey, look, it's my dream, my goal to have a house, a second home somewhere. Why wait? Right? Why give up those 5 years when you're working and you can use it? Because ultimately, the financial plan may be, say, it doesn't matter, right? You may be at a 99% probability of success, and you may go with a house to a 99. Do it. Don't give up those 5 years. I got a story. I had a client that came in about 5-6 years ago. They were about 5 years from retirement, and they said, our dream is ultimately to live in Arizona. We want a house in Arizona. The wife didn't do well here in the cold weather with some health issues. And I'd done enough financial plans to say, you guys can afford this now. What did they do? Bought it. She moved down there while he finished up his last 3 years of work up here, right? They split time and they love it. They would have never known that if they wouldn't have came in and talked to me.
And are they living down there full time now?
Yes, sir.
Awesome. Yeah. That's awesome.
And in fact, I get to go see them once a year because it was that important to them that we told them they could do it. Because ultimately, we didn't rob them of the most precious commodity we all have, which is time, right?
Yeah, you know, there's something to be said about that, Logan. We call it living your one best financial life. And when you say dream and dream big, let's build that ideal plan first, and then let's go from there. And we've all had similar experiences working with clients over the years. And the critical foundation to it is making sure that the complete financial plan using our guided retirement system is in place and it's updated on a regular basis. Because when these things come along, we want to be able to give great advice and we want to be able to do it soon. I had a client of mine a few years ago, a lot of family from Wisconsin. And so we had built in all of these trips and travel and everything that they wanted to do. And it was laid out perfectly. COVID hits, and they're not able to do the traveling they want. So they call and say, Dean, what would happen to our ability to continue to travel and do all the things we want if we would buy a second home in Wisconsin? I said, well, let's go through the math. Let's see what happens. We plugged it into their plan. And you know what? They were able to do it. Their plan worked, them actually buying that house. Now, we had to go through a lot of scenarios because while they had enough cash to pay for the house, not all of the cash was in taxable accounts. They would have had to withdraw some pretty big money from IRAs in order to do it. So we wound up putting about 30% down, taking a mortgage out for the rest, and then just set up a systematic withdrawal to make the mortgage payment.
And Dean, that's really a great point, because people that are doing this themselves without a financial plan aren't thinking about, well, maybe I want a $400,000 house. It's going to cost a lot more than $400,000. The time you pay federal and state taxes. One more thing, right? How old are they? Think about Medicare premiums, right? You got to have the tax plan with the overall plan. And if you don't, you're going to be surprised, right?
And you're exactly right. And you know, another thing when people start thinking about a second home, and that generally happens from what I've seen, it's a few years into retirement. And when people start thinking about that second home, one of the things I have to remind them of is that you're not going to have two homes forever.
Right.
There's going to become a point in your life at which you're not physically able or not wanting to travel back and forth and be able to upkeep two different locations, right? So what's the period of time that we're going to own this for? And when we sell that second home, whether it be the one they're in the primary residence and they move to the second home, or the second homes get sold and they continue to live in their primary residence, whatever, that money's going to come right back into the plan. That has to be taken into consideration.
And you know, the best part of our jobs every day is I took on a client about a year ago, and we went through the planning process, and I was like, you guys are going to leave a lot of money behind. And they kind of said, well, we have this idea, right? It's always just been an idea, but hey, we're not rich. We're not going to be able to afford a second home, right? The stigma that, oh, I have two houses. Went through the planning process and said, you guys can afford this second home. And they said, I just don't ever know if we will do it, right? Went down, looked, got a phone call. Are you sure we can do this? Absolutely, right? They did it, right? And they love it. If you don't know what you don't know, right?
That's
right. That's the most important thing.
Well, and think about what we try to provide is clarity, so that people can then have confidence in the decisions that they're making, ultimately putting them in control of their own financial life. Without the financial plan created in the first place, it would be virtually impossible for people to see that this is reality, because typically you're going to have one person in the family that is that more conservative. We can't afford it. We don't know what's going to happen. We shouldn't spend that money now. We don't know what's going to happen in the future. And you got the one person saying, look, we're only going to live once. Can't we just do this? And they go back and forth. And we're there to say, let's not think about this from an emotional level. Let's look at the facts. And let's look at, and if it can happen, are there trade-offs that need to be made? Or can you continue doing everything you want to do? And once you get all those facts up front, then you can ultimately make the right decision.
Yeah, and that's really the most important thing, because we say, you and I say all the time, hey, if you don't spend this money, you're going to leave a lot behind, right? Okay, buy that second home. Spend time with the grandkids at the beach or the mountains, whatever you guys prefer. You can't take away that time. What's more important, to enjoy it while you're there with them, or ultimately leave them an asset?
You reminded me of a scenario that's played out, a pretty big deal to me over the last couple of years. Began a planning relationship with a couple several years ago, and we've done a lot of work on getting money into a tax-free situation. We've done a lot of Roth conversions, and we've really set this couple up to where there's no possible way they can spend even the interest that their accounts are making. And so their goal, one of their big goals, was to leave money to their two daughters and their grandkids. And so we started a conversation. Now, this is a big purchase discussion, because I said, what if we could do things today for your granddaughters and their families, or your daughters and their families? And what if we could do things today that you guys could actually witness and see and experience and give from warm hands as opposed to cold hands? So I said, think about what you'd like to do. And so the husband and wife went and they talked about it, and they said, okay, here's what we want to do. We want to start giving dollars. We want to allow our one daughter and her husband to buy a home with a mother-in-law quarters, right? So that in the event that they need a place to stay in the future, they can have the family there. They did it, okay, for one daughter. The other daughter said, we've always wanted a lake home. Great. They bought the lake home. And so here's a scenario where this guy comes into my office and he sits down. He said, Dean, I would have never, ever done these things without your counsel. And without the planning work that we had done, we could have never given the counsel that we did.
And that's what we see every single day. And you know, doing a lot of first meetings, get to know meetings with people, they always say, well, you say every financial plan is different, but is it really? Absolutely, it's different.
They're all different.
It's what you want to do. At the end of the day, a good financial planner is there to give options, right? So we can make educated decisions. You mentioned something earlier, right? You had to do a lot of planning in that first scenario. A lot of people come in and say, I will never take out a mortgage, right? I haven't had one in 15 years. I'm not going to get one now. And that's fine, right? Rates are low. Maybe it makes sense. Maybe it doesn't. But it's our job to give you options.
Yeah, no, you're exactly right. And I think the thing is that when you talk about large purchases in retirement, what you're talking about is the fact that we all have just one life. And as we've learned in the last several months with COVID and all the other things that are going on, that life is precious. It could be short. I had clients that had parents in in hospitals and things. They couldn't even go see them, right?
Yeah.
And so
babies being born.
Right. It's just crazy, and you never know what's going to come. And so if you can get what I will call permission to do the things that you want to do, and you can see in black and white that it's possible and it's not going to affect your lifestyle and it's not going to affect your ability to continue to increase that income to keep up with inflation in the future, then all of a sudden you're making an informed and intelligent decision. You're not making a decision based on an emotion.
Right. And at the end of the day, the only way to do what you're talking about doing is with true financial planning, not an investment advisor, right? It's a certified financial planner with a team of insurance, CPAs, right?
State planning attorneys, yeah.
Right? Because if you got to look at the tax side of things, right?
Absolutely.
And if you don't, then you're going to be in for a rude awakening.
Well, you said a little bit ago, Logan, that, you know, people, once they get out of debt, they can't envision going back into debt. Well, in the scenario of the couple I told you earlier, they didn't want to go back into debt. But I said, look, in order to get enough money to buy that house, here's going to be your tax hit by taking it out of the IRA, or we can finance it. And here's how much we have to take out. Here's your tax hit. And at the end of the day, Logan, the amount of money that they're going to leave behind to their kids and their grandkids is so much greater by taking out that mortgage than it was if we'd have taken all the money out of the IRA, paid the taxes, and paid cash for the house.
And the beautiful thing about it is that's a great planning technique. But if you do take out a mortgage and you decide 2 years into it, Dean, I just can't do it, you're not in debt, right? Because if you can write a check, you're not in debt. It's just smart leverage, right?
There is smart debt. Right. But there's also crazy debt, and the crazy debt's what you want to avoid. But there is smart debt. Another example, had a client here a few years ago that says, hey, I've always wanted this exotic car. Right. It was like $110,000 sports car.
Nice car.
OK, nice car. And can I buy that car? And so we go through the planning process. Yeah, you can buy the car. And you know what? They had a special 0% financing on it. So we didn't have to take all the money out.
No reason not to use their money.
Right. Yeah. And there's so many scenarios, Logan, but I think the key and what I want people to understand is that when you talk about making a large purchase in retirement, there's not a book to read on it. There's not a set of rules of doing that. The only way that you're going to be able to figure out, can I do it or should I not? Is there going to be a trade-off? Is to have that comprehensive financial plan done and be working with all the professionals under one roof so that you're taking everything into consideration before you make that decision.
And I can't stress enough the importance of doing it sooner than later, yep. Right? Why rob yourself of that extra 5 or 10 years in that house in Florida or Arizona or wherever you want to go, right? I'll put you on the spot here. Where do you have the most fun with your family?
At my lake house.
Exactly. What about if you would have waited till retirement to gotten that? How many years would you have given up of summers and memories and time?
It's irreplaceable.
It's not always about money.
Well, money is the engine, right? The engine, the fuel that allows you to do those things. But Logan, when you sit down with people for the first time and you say, all right, let's talk about what's really important to you. Let's prioritize the things in your life that are most important. How many times has somebody come to you and said, well, the most important thing to me is how big my bank account is? Never. That's just not it, right? Money's how we get to do the things that we want to do. And without the right education and the right planning techniques, people don't really know what's possible.
It's true, Dean. And it's okay, maybe they know they have enough money to do this, but what's the distribution planning? What's the taxes going to look like? What's the Medicare cost going to look like? How do I say this all the time. People come to us and they have this stuff. They've worked hard. They have Social Security. They maybe have a pension. Now, how do we make that work for you in the most tax-efficient manner? That's ultimately why I have a job and why you have a job.
Right, and what you're drilling down to there, Logan, is the critical part. And I think a lot of people, our industry has done a poor job of explaining what certified financial planners do. Our industry, the financial industry, has made people believe that the investments are the most important part of an overall financial plan. But really, investments are the last piece that should be ever discussed because you really can't even define what that money needs to do until you've done all the planning.
And it's ever changing, right? We talk about it all the time, financial planning is dynamic. Because I may have a client that's retired for 3 years and they may come to me and say, hey, we're going to get a house, right? That could ultimately change how your investments need to be managed.
Right.
Absolutely. That's why we sit down with our clients a couple times a year, maybe quarterly, to review these things.
You have to do it. You have to. And when that plan is built and those things come up in your life that you say, okay, what would happen if we did this? What would that do? Do we have to make some trade-offs or are we good to do it? And that's, I like what you said. That's kind of the most rewarding part of what we do is actually witnessing people being able to do the things that they
telling want. Telling them they can retire, right? And, right. And these big expenses, and you just said it, right? Your best memories in the last 5 or 10 years are at your lake house.
Yep.
Right?
No question. No question. I mean, we've taken some great trips on top of that, but I mean, those are things that my kids will, you know, they'll remember forever. It's a big deal. You know, just a quick personal story, Logan. When I started in this business and started doing financial planning and I started realizing and watching people go into retirement and not doing the things they want to do, how critical it was that I coach them, that I teach them, that I give them that permission slip. And then I actually said, I'm going to take that and put it into my personal life, right? And these are the things that I'm going to do. When my kids were in school, we used to, we had a motorhome at that point in time. Mm-hmm. The day they got out of school, we load up the motorhome. And this was before the GPS and smartphones. My wife would get out the Atlas and we'd hop in the motorhome. We'd head out. We'd go for a month and can't get that back, right? But I knew whatever that cost, I already knew that I was saving enough to get to where I wanted to be. So I had permission to actually spend that money. And I love what you said earlier. If you can do it now, why wait? But some people get into this mindset, I've got to continue to save. I got to continue to build that nest egg. And maybe you're already there.
You've won the game.
Yeah.
Right? And defining winning is different for everyone, right? So you get the question all the time, how much money do I need to retire? I don't know. Depends.
It depends on what you want.
But at the end of the day, and I think you would agree with me here, the worst thing a financial planner can do, and I mentioned this earlier, is rob someone of the most precious commodity we all have, which is time. Right? Because ultimately, we want lifelong clients of Barber Financial Group. And if I work with a client for 15 years, right, maybe at that point, 20 years, they don't have their health. And I talking to them, they say, I got this pile of money, but gosh, Logan, I wish you would have told me 10, 15 years ago, I could have done these things. And now I can't. That's not a position I ever want to be in, nor do you.
No. And the cool thing is that almost 35 years of doing this, I'm working with third generations of people, and they get to see what did I do for grandma, what did I do for mom and dad, and let's put that into place for me. And so that's rewarding. And the other thing that I want people to really understand is that it's not about a financial product. And there are so many people in the financial services industry that are only interested in selling a product to earn a commission. And that's one thing that we never, ever do.
Quick story about that. I had a client come in at the time that had, you know, been tied up in an annuity, right? You had the surrender period, you have to hold it. Didn't make any sense to get out of it. They weren't liquid enough, right? They had the money to do this,
but they couldn't,
do it, right? It was, and we had to wait 5 years. What's been the theme of this video, right? Time.
Yeah,
that's sad.
Because they got sold a product. And nobody should ever be sold a product. That's why I say investments should never be discussed until the plan is done. And then you can lay out, okay, here's all the options of how you can accomplish what you want to accomplish. Let's pick the one that you're most comfortable with.
And for me, it was a hopeless feeling in that situation because there was nothing I could do, right? Because of a previous act by another financial planner.
Yeah, or they called themselves a financial planner, but they really were just a product
salesman. Product salesman.
Right, and that those people are rampant in our industry. The industry's tried to change it, but the lobbyists are too strong to really enact great change. So it's critical when people are looking for a good financial planning firm that they look for a firm that's got great CPAs, great estate planning attorneys, great certified financial planners, and the risk management experts that are all going to collaborate together on behalf of that individual.
At the end of the day, your financial planner, whoever you're working with, whether it's at Barber Financial Group or whatever company, should be playing quarterback for you. It's my job as certified financial planner to get with Joanne, our CPA, right? Get with our estate planning attorneys, get with our insurance specialist, get with Jason, who runs our centralized financial planning department, right? It's my job to do that.
And that's why you're here.
Exactly.
Well, hopefully everybody's enjoyed our discussion here about making a large purchase during retirement. The theme, again, I want you to get here is that there's not a rule book for making a large purchase in retirement. And the real truth is that your retirement should be what you want. So if you're not already a client of Barber Financial Group, you can get a complimentary consultation with one of our certified financial planners, and we'll start with the discussion about what it is that's on your mind, what it is that you want your life to look like, and We'll talk about how we do what we do, and we'll see if there's any need to move forward. But we'd love an opportunity to sit down with you and start that complimentary consultation so that you can live your one best financial life. Thanks so much for joining us here, and I hope that you enjoyed this. I want you to know that we're here to answer any questions that you may have. So if you're joining us on YouTube, you can click the link and get a complimentary consultation with one of our certified financial planners. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends.